this is the first time we do a session together with the Ukrainian Association in Ukraine. Years before we did in Austria together with the Ukrainian Association, but now it's the first time we are here. And we are on an official mission, and therefore our president has joined us and is with us. And I think you will are for making everything possible for us. And now I ask our president, Dr. Wernicke, to give his introduction.
Thank you very much again. My heartfelt congratulations to Professor Pogorozhniuk at this anniversary. I just want to introduce to you the Austrian Society of Bone and Mineral. Please. Okay, it was founded in 1991, so we are not that old, if you want. It was founded during an ECTS Congress in Vienna, and the founding fathers was Professor Peterlik and Klaus Kraushofer, who some of you might know for his work in bone structure. The aim of our society is to to give an interdisciplinary approach to bone. Bone is actually used, the field of bone is, it accommodates lots of specialties. There are MDs and PhDs, it's basic, it's clinical. We have internal medicine, gynecologists, we have orthopedians, physical medicine and rehabilitation, and we also have dental medicine here, as you will hear in the very nice talk of Professor Gruber. We aim to intensify research by corporations nationally and, of course, internationally, and that's why we are here as well. We provide clinical guidance based on scientific evidence, so-called Leitlinien. We provide education and a voice for bone specialists of other societies, like the Endocrine Society. It was one of the mistakes that the Germans, for example, made. They have all the societies, the endocrinologists and the rheumatologists and so on and so on. And they don't have a real platform where osteology is housed, so they actually focused on a super society that accommodates all of this, but it's quite differently than in our country. We are more on the not, let's put it that way, not on the rival side, but more in a collegial together. Please. Today we have approximately 300 members in Austria. We have had a quite good scientific output for the last 15 years. We have international cooperation with Germany, Switzerland, the US, of course, now Ukraine as well. We are members of the ILF, of the ECTS, and of the DDO. And I just want to introduce for your focus the significant research groups in Austria. We have the Medical University of Vienna. There is a basic research group led by Professor Pietschmann, which focuses on osteoimmunology and osteoclastogenesis. We have the Medical University of Graz with endocrinology, orthopedics. There are multiple groups, but they are working together. They are doing clinical studies in bone metabolism. They are doing bone genetics, microRNAs, as epidemiology, and implant research. Please continue. We have the Ludwig Boltzmann Institute of Osteology in Vienna, the formerly group of Klaus Kraushofer, now led by Jochen Zerina, which is a basic, not only basic research group, but focused on basic research in bone structure. They have published some really first-class papers on bone mineralization and bone microstructure, as well as epigenetics. We have we have the WinForce group in Vienna, led by Professor Resch and with the members of Christian Muschitz and Judith Haschka, who will also give a very nice talk, Roland Kotschian, focused on clinical research and treatment studies, secondary bone loss, also microRNA and bone structure. And we have the University of Dental Medicine in Vienna, the group of Reinhard Gruber in oral biology and implantology. The Austrian Society awards stipends and prizes for individual project support. We support also dissertants with the Felix Bronner stipend and the Ertheim Prize for basic research. The most renowned prize we offer is the International Research Prize. There are some laureates like Anna Tetti, Jack Martin, Henry Cronenberg, and Joseph Penninger, whose names you might know. The 2018 awardee was Michael P. White for his work on hypophosphatasia. We also feature some conferences. Yearly is the Austrian Osteoporosis Forum, which is a primarily educational forum in St. Wolfgang. It's clinically oriented, it's in May, and we also have the Biennial Austrian Bone Conference, which is not in that way educational, but more research oriented in clinically, basically, and where we had the pleasure to host also the laureate from yesterday, Professor Pogrosniuk. I just want to finish with an invitation for corporations. Whenever you have a project, the financing of research is getting more and more difficult all over Europe. So I think the future of clinical and basic research, clinical research that's not sponsored by a pharmaceutical company, the aim should be to actually really go into multinational corporations, lots of groups working together. They all benefit from publishing the paper with their names on it. They all advance their careers, and the output is usually better than when you struggle for money alone. So if you're looking for partners for research project, don't hesitate. This is our website with the impression. You can always contact us, the ABMS office, or me personally. I'm looking forward to this. Many thanks again to the Ukrainian organizers, Professor Pogrosniuk, the Institute, and the osteologists in Ukraine for this kind of invitation. And with that, I'm concluding and give way for the real, more interesting scientific talk. Thank you.
Thank you.